So I'm Scott from South Florida Insider, and I'm here with
Steve from 30 Vegas.
You know, earlier this morning, got to see your set over at the W Hotel, and now over here at Ultra, kind of a nice balance between two totally different worlds, it seems. How does it feel? I know you haven't really entered into Ultra yet, but what's been the feel so far?
I mean, the whole experience here in Miami's, you know, every street that you turn down and every hotel that you're around, everybody's like, you know, this is Ultra Weekend, this is electronic music's kind of, you know, joining the forces, and I think so far the experience is, it's just like, you know, hooray, you know, finally dance music's getting recognized in this country.
And how does it feel? I mean, the recent album, it's kind of like kind of a unified thing, bringing everybody back together to put out, what is this, the third album now?
Yes, it'll be our third artist album. Like for us, we're just looking around and seeing what music's out there, and there's cool bands and you know, great DJs of every genre, and you know, we're just pleased to be part of that, and you know, for us, we're just writing material and getting back out there.
Was it ever really like a break, or was it, I mean, how do you explain what went on between the second album and this third album? Because it didn't happen right away.
No, I mean, there was a three-year gap from 2005 to 2008. Then we started to put out music. We went right back to our club roots and put out tracks on a UK label called Tool Room. And we did a compilation on Stealth, just finding our roots again. And then the songs just came, you know. And now here we are, just about to release the new record and head out on tour pretty much most parts of the world.
Did the album kind of like seems like something that was kind of ready in the making over the time that passed between working together?
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, we listen to music all the time, and I think when you're in a band, or you know, when you're working in the music business, you're analysing everything, and you know, you're listening to other people's stuff and you're taking it apart, and you know, as soon as you step away from that on a break, you become a music fan again, and you just appreciate the music for what it is, a song, a track, you know. And you know, we soaked all that up from people that we're into, and got in the studio and just started to work.
Maybe it's just me, but I got kind of the feel, like, opening track of the album, you guys had kind of like a Killers type feel. Was that anything like you guys were listening to, or?
Yeah, I mean, you know, we're huge fans of the Killers and you know, bands like Phoenix and Mike Snow and stuff, you know, we just, all of them influences. I mean, it's 10 years ago we put our album out, where we took, you know, dance music onto a stage with a drummer and guitarist, and, you know, we're all from a live music background, and I mean, you know, we're definitely influenced, you know, by a lot of them bands that are around today.
And I know you're pretty much swarmed with the attention right now, so just kind of wrapping things up, I mean, what's the future hold for the band?
Lots of dates, new album, like US tour, festivals. We're booked for festivals all over the world, and you know, just on the stage doing what we do.
All right, well, I appreciate your time. Thanks a lot.